Today we're going to tear down the BlackBerry Priv. The actual build of this phone is pretty complex, but the two most important repairs, a battery swap and a screen replacement, are surprisingly easy, and I'll show you what I mean throughout the video. First thing, remove the SIM card tray and the SD card tray. They're both along the top. Once those are out, you can peel back the back cover from the phone. Make sure to watch out for the power button and volume buttons. Those will just unsnap from the frame. And then you can slide the phone out from the back cover. Pretty simple. Here you can see the rear 18 megapixel camera, and then a couple of the antennas that are along the back of the phone with the NFC pad and the QI charging pad. All of these have little contact points that just rest on the motherboard. Here's a close-up shot of the contact points on the motherboard and the contact points on the pads. And remove this plastic shield. And for the next step, you'll need a screwdriver. This one is a T5 screw. It's holding the battery in place. You can just unplug the battery. It's just like a little Lego piece that snaps into the main board. Pretty straightforward. And to remove the battery, it does help out a lot if the battery is a little bit heated up. It'll soften the adhesive behind the battery, and you can use a little pull tab to pull it up. You really do not want to pry this battery out at all, and I'll show you why in just a second. Here behind the battery, you can see that there are some small ribbon cables that are very, very easy to rip. They're for the power button. Here's the battery itself. You can see it is a 3400 milliamp battery. There are two screws down here for the loudspeaker. There's a little housing with some funky white glue surrounding it. You can remove the freaky white glue, and then the loudspeaker will just pop out from the housing itself. Pretty cool, pretty easy to replace. I will link all the replacement parts down in the video description. There's a little protective cover over the headphone jack as well, and then there are 8 screws on the main board. Once those 8 screws are removed, they're all the T5s as well. You can take off these little connectors, they're for the screen, and they just pop off like little Legos. And then this one down here is for the keyboard, you can pop that off as well. And then the main board can be removed from the frame of the device. There is one more cable along the bottom for the power button. You can just unclip that as well. And here you can see the thermal paste for the Qualcomm 808 processor. It'll help dissipate the heat from the processor onto the mainframe of the phone. And here's the camera, the rear 18 megapixel camera. So you can see here the screen and the slider mechanism. The headphone jack just falls out from the frame. You can see that it has a bunch of little connection pads that just rest up against the motherboard. And that's how it receives its signal. The rest of these screws are a bit smaller. I'm going to use my T4 driver. There's 8 of them that hold the keyboard part of the frame onto the screen part of the frame. So we're going to remove that from the sliding mechanism. Just make sure that the screen ribbon cables slide through the little slot in the keyboard frame. So let's take a look at the keyboard. The keyboard is stuck to the frame relatively permanently. If you remove the keyboard, you will have to find some way to adhere it. I do have to fix my keypad though, because of my durability video, I did mess up the keypad a little bit. So we're going to tuck that back in. It looks like the keyboard can be replaced, it just depends on how they sell the replacement parts. If it comes with the copper piece, you can remove that from the frame. If the keyboard comes without the copper piece, make sure you leave the copper backing installed on the frame and just remove the keyboard section. I'm going to put my keyboard back on. I will have to use some kind of super glue or something else to adhere it because there is no residual adhesive on the back of the plastic. So here is the sliding mechanism. It's a bunch of these little wire springs that you can detach from the front frame. And if you're gonna remove this section, you wanna lift it up over the gold little doohickey, fold up the ribbon cables and tuck it down into the screen. This is a fairly difficult process, so I would recommend not touching this sliding mechanism unless you have to. It is not essential to repairing the screen, and I will show you that in just a second. I did end up bending this part of the frame just a little bit to slide it out from the little grooves. This next part is not essential to a screen replacement either. It is only important if you're trying to get into the front camera. There's a little metal bracket and one more screw as well, and then you can just remove the front 2 megapixel camera from its little holster. It's a tiny little guy, not super important. Now here's the screen, and let me show you how easy this is. It is way easier than the Galaxy screens, where there is a bunch of adhesive on the LCD and the glass, and you gotta make sure not to break anything. There is only adhesive surrounding the edge of the BlackBerry Priv, which is very nice. I found it easiest to go in from where the earpiece is, because there's not a whole lot of glue, and there's a little slot between the frame and the glass. So once I lifted that up, I could slide a business card in between the glass and the frame. That QR code just takes you to my YouTube channel. Speaking of which, if you've enjoyed this video so far, make sure you've hit that subscribe button. It does help me keep making videos like this into the future. Now that I've heated up the phone, my business card will slip in. Make sure you don't put it too far into the top of the phone, and I'll show you why in just a second. But once you pop out through the side, you can just take it and slide it all the way down as long as the phone is still warm from the heat gun. I usually get it to about just where it's too hot to touch, and the card will just slice through the adhesive all the way down to the bottom of the phone. and you can just slice through the bottom of the phone as well. Super simple. I imagine that a professional technician could replace this screen in about 5 or 10 minutes once they're used to the operation. It's a pretty impressive design. There's one ribbon cable underneath holding the LCD onto that screen extension cable that we were talking about before. Now that I've unplugged that, we can see the part that I was warning you about. Now, if your screen's shattered or broken, you don't need to worry about damaging it anymore. Since my screen is working, I want to keep it functional. Now, about this point during my teardown, this is where I realized that the screen can be removed without actually opening up the phone. You can see that your new replacement screen can just be plugged into the body while everything is still intact, which is fantastic. Now I'm going back into the track mechanism. I'm going to put the phone back together just to prove that the screen can be replaced without the phone being taken apart. Now the track mechanism is put back together. I'm going to put in the front-facing camera, put the back fragile plastic pieces back into place. Now if you did take apart your sliding mechanism, make sure you line up the flex ribbon cable with the little holes in the frame so that the ribbon won't be pinched when you're sliding the phone up and down. Then you can take the screen extension cable and slide it through the keyboard section of the frame. It will end up near the top of the little slot. There are 8 screws. Then you can take your 18 megapixel rear camera and plug it back into the mainboard. Plug your power button into the bottom of the mainboard. Fold that over and put it back onto the frame. There are 8 screws holding the motherboard onto the frame of the phone. Then you plug in all of your ribbon cables, like the keyboard and the 2 screen extensions. Put in your loudspeaker with the protective black housing. The housing for the headphone jack, get those 3 screws back into place. Now that the phone is completely assembled, let's install the screen. It just plugs into the main body of the phone, just like a little Lego piece and all of the other connections we've been working with. And then most of replacement screens come with adhesive pre-installed, so just remove the protective covering over the adhesive and then set the screen down into place and you're done. I'm gonna plug in the battery, make sure the phone works by pressing the power button, and everything is great. Pretty fantastic design. I'm impressed that the screen can be replaced so easily. Screw the battery back in, and then you can tuck it back into the back housing, starting with the bottom and just moving your way up the sides, clipping it down into place. Put the SIM card and the SD card trays back in, and everything is good. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them down in the comments below. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and subscribe. It does help me out a lot. Thanks for watching.